Welcome to New York Stereoscopic Association presents.
So good they named it twice. New York, New York, all the scandal and the vice. I love it, New York, New York. Now isn't it a pity? What they're doing to New York, doing to New York, doing to New York City.
Now it's my pleasure to introduce the folks who contributed to this week's gallery, We the People. It was very broad assignment. It was a broad assignment, so it includes 2D and 3D chroma depth and stuff. So first will be Tony Brown, who is a retired physics technician and amateur photographer living in Ireland, and who, like many of us, developed an addiction to stereoscopic 3D. Next up will be Dave Ross, who is a camera assistant for the film and TV industry in New York City. He shoots with a stereo realist and medium format, and so he's still mounting film. Hooray for Dave. While we're on that topic of film, in the coming weeks we'll have a seminar on how to cut and mount stereo slides. I know it's a step backwards, man, but it's the coolest thing in the world. You know, anybody who does that knows how much more control you have and stuff. But of course, it's harder to share. Anyway, Martin Shubb is a retired electrical engineer and physicist who's been taking stereo photos since the 1980s and is a member of the Minnesota Stereo Photography Club. They're lucky to have such a talented member, and we thank them for loaning him to us. Theo van Damme hails from the Netherlands and began his journey into stereoscopic playland when he was first introduced to a Viewmaster as a child, like many of us. He's a longtime member of the Dutch Stereo Club, the German DGS, we'll have to ask him what that means later, and the ISU, where he's given workshops. You know, that's one of the things I love most about this community. Everyone's always willing to lend you a hand, because the stereo racket can be pretty complicated at times. Christopher Zelenka is my youngest son and has been shooting with a Fuji W3 ever since I gave him one. He also traveled across the United States and documented his journey with a Viewmaster film camera. His lifelong interest in photography. Johnny Laser, on the other hand, you don't need to know anything about. Needs no introduction. Billy Haas is a graphic designer and visual artist based in New Jersey. Her background includes a degree in visual arts and technology from Stevens Institute of Technology that, by the way, was broadcasting experimental 3D television in the late 90s to New York City on a UHF channel at the school controlled at that time. Back to Billy. She's done production work as an engineering associate at World Stage here in New York and worked for Live Nation, the company that produces mega events with the biggest stars. During one of those events, I was fortunate enough to have our paths cross. Poor girl. Anyway, now without further ado, on with the show. We're going to begin with a video from Tony Brown. And I'll tell you, it's a very nice, relaxing, wonderful video. I'm going to let you decide. We have got his permission to rename it, and we named it We the Peeps.
Right. Well, I'm a new kid on the block with this game. I've been an enthusiastic photographer all my life. And only in my 82nd year did a very talented gentleman nudge me into playing with 3D. So at the very end of it, because I like cha-cha camera work, I had to buy a Fuji W3 3D camera. And thanks to the discovery of Dubois technique, I was able to do 3D anaglyphs in color. Which this is, that's a European robin, and most of these others are coal tits, and this is the robin's quite aggressive, this one. And I set it up in the frame so that the birds go backwards out of the frame or forwards out of the frame, depending on theirs. It's a bit of fun, there's no purpose behind it. But I wouldn't like to produce handheld video in 3D. I think it would be a terrible strain on the eyes, so I mounted it on a tripod. It's only a couple of minutes altogether. I haven't actually found another use for the Fuji yet, but maybe.
Hey, Tony, fun is a serious endeavor. I just want you to know that. That's what we do. We're on a serious endeavor here, but fun is a serious endeavor, and thank you. You gave us fun, and that was a wonderful, peaceful moment, man. Thank you.
You're welcome.
That was great.
There's a huge number of these ancient ecclesiastical ruins in Ireland, and they make fabulous subjects for 3D, mainly because with having no roof on them, there's daylight in all the sectors. This is an old Franciscan friary from the 15th century, and it's very extensive. There's dormitories, refectories, and the like, and it makes a fabulous background. It's on the border between County Galway and County Mayo, and there's a river between, and they had in the kitchens, they have a pool, a stone pool, which they used to keep the fish in live until they wanted them. They get the fish from the river. But it's in magnificent condition, and it's owned now by the Office of Public Works in Ireland, so they maintain it very well. And all these old buildings, in spite of being ruined, they all have cemeteries, and the cemeteries are in current use. People still pile into them in due course. So it's not a dead building. It's used by the local population.
I like the way you described it, Tony. Pile into them in due course. Well, that needs a patoom. That needs a rim shot.
This is another one in a place called Clare Galway, and it's an older, it's a 13th century Franciscan monastery. In fact, there's a great similarity in the designs. They must have had blueprints that they handed out, because the towers and the corners and the design of them is almost identical, and they could be 100 miles apart, which in the 13th century would have been quite an obstacle. That's a modern cemetery in the grounds of the friary you just saw.
Where did you live before Ireland?
North of Liverpool, a place called Southport, where there's a lot of fancy golf courses.
I guess you shot 2D there.
All 2D until my 82nd birthday. Well, sorry, my 81st birthday. So it's just this last year that I've been playing with this, and it's great fun. I love it.
Now, where is this?
This is the church you just saw in Clare Galway. It's about 12 miles from where I live. Now, that, I hate to say, is taken on a mobile phone that I was forced to buy recently, because the bank decided not to let me get at my money unless I had a mobile phone. I bet you all have the same pressure. But the pictures are quite good from it. It's just, you know, I just find it unnatural to hold a slate board up when you're trying to take a picture of something.
So, right.
You can't point it.
What did you process? How did you use Photoshop? What did you do?
Well, I used, because of the photograph that, oh no, these were cha-chas, but I used Stereophoto Maker, and I bow down in appreciation of all the work that's gone into that piece of software.
We're all kneeling right now, the entire crowd, in that direction.
It's beautiful. But I do use Photoshop on occasion when I need to insert something from one cha-cha frame to the other in the correct layer.
Okay, well, I'll jump right into it. Hi, folks. This photo I took with my stereo realist this summer on a camping trip as a bit of relief from the pandemic. This was in Harriman State Park, which is, I'm sure all of you New York Cityers know that it's north of the city. This is just my friend Ted. And so all these photos that I'll be showing today are just friends and family that I have been able to spend time with at some point during the pandemic. This one is my friend Ted on the left, Ben in the middle, Chad on the right. These are my three best friends in Brooklyn. And we all took a bike trip up somewhere north of the city. I don't remember where this was. This was actually in Connecticut. So we all just met up at this post office and did a day bike ride around. And yeah, this was maybe May or June or earlier last year, but one of very, very few times of actually spending face time with other people.
Hey, listen, you could have done the post office a favor by grabbing a couple of bags and doing some deliveries. They've been brutal lately, man. Oh my God.
I've given them a lot of my money in the last year. Again, my friend Ben, this is the roof of his apartment building in Brooklyn in Clinton Hill neighborhood. And, this was, again, all three of these have been stereo realist. And I actually faked the sky on this. I know I shouldn't reveal the secrets, but this I Photoshopped the sky in stereo. But everything else, even without the sky, I was always very pleased with how this one came out.
No, it's great. What kind of film are you using?
That was, must have been Provia, Fujifilm, a slide film. This is the same camping trip as the first photo of my friend Ted and his girlfriend Mookie. And this was actually the ones that are realist are on a realist 7P, which I modified last year some point. I'm sure folks who are familiar with the realist over the last couple decades, you know, some people modified their 7P, so it can be wider than it is tall.
Was that a pandemic project or a pre-pandemic project?
Pandemic project. I had read about it on George's website and dreamed about it. And it wasn't until I was really just sitting around a whole bunch that it got to opening things up and seeing how easy it is to actually make that.
You've done good. It looks great, man. It's excellent. Excellent.
Yeah, I'm very happy with that. And this is one of very few photos that I've taken with my TL120, which is the big monstrous, the 3D world medium format stereo camera with three, you know, full size lenses. This is my girlfriend Anna and her family and all the dogs. They live in upstate New York. And so they're the only people in the family that we've been able to, like any family that we've been able to visit in the last year.
And what so, film, what film are you using in the medium format?
I think this was Ektachrome E100. And I also, you know, I haven't shot very much with that camera since I got it last year, but I've also been for the first time been shooting off, off camera flash. So this was, also an experiment at Phil Flash. It's not very, it's very subtle, but anyway, I'm always trying to learn something new every time I shoot another roll of film.
Looks like that was actually, I'll ask you a few questions quickly. So that was a movie theater. It looks like a movie theater marquee, right? It's not a...
That's right, yeah. It's our neighborhood movie theater, one of the last of its kind.
What's happening with it now?
Well, they're closed down there to make keep the lights on and keep the pipes from freezing. They're selling popcorn, so we go there and get popcorn every so often. But for a while, when the state has relaxed things enough, they'll rent it out for a very reduced number of people, but yeah, mostly they're dark.
Let's hope we see theaters again, because it was a fun experience. You know, you took it for granted, right? Go to the, I'm not going to go. No, we took that for granted. Let's hope it's going to come back in some form. We hope.
Well, what city is this, please?
Sorry, this is Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Oh, great. My sister lives in St. Paul.
Yeah, small world. But I, you know, the at the time the assignment went out, the Capitol riots were on my mind, among other things. And so I just really like the sentiment. They've been, so instead of advertising shows, they've been putting up quotes from movies or from actors. And this is one of those.
And Theo, now you just obviously in Photoshop, do you want to give me a little hint on what you did, if you'd like to?
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Perfectly.
Okay. Well, it was this Christmas decoration material, these stars, that got me to the idea. It was, of course, January 6th. And I thought all the stars in America were shaking, and let's try to combine it. So I had a stereo picture from these little stars, and actually it wasn't Photoshop. I'm working with Affinity Photo, but it's practically the same materials that you can handle with. And so a lot of layers and shifting with the transparency, etc. But this is not the final picture. Earlier this morning, I sent it in a better version, but it was a bit too late to get it into the show. Well, sorry about that.
No, well, I would say this. That's really, you know, well, I could say that I'm gonna speak on the behalf of all Americans. All right, how's that? Johnny Lazer's taking it. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And okay. Listen. And you know, look, here's the thing. Hey, Americans, don't listen to this. You know we're crazy over here. You know that. When we get it wrong, we really get it wrong. But when we get it right, we change the world. And don't worry, we'll be okay. Okay, Americans, you can listen again.
Okay. Good luck then.
Yes, thank you so much, Theo. Thank you. While Chris is plying his trade today, I'll take responsibility for explaining some of his images. This was taken while on a protest against gun violence in March of 2018. He used a W3. Of course, this is the Lincoln Memorial. And Jamie will explain in a minute what those hand signals mean.
Common myth is that he is using sign language with his hands right there. It makes an A and an L.
And of course, this is the shot that Lincoln is looking at. He's looking at the Washington Monument. And this guy sure has a nice hat. The problem is you have to put a bolt in your head to wear this. But other than that, it's really it's a real chic.
It's a great hat. You got to give the guy that, huh?
And this doesn't need much of an explanation. Now you know this guy. So I'm going to keep moving right into it. Here we are. Now this shot, this is from the video of President Biden's inauguration on January 20th. When I was watching it, I noticed how the camera seemed like it was on a dolly moving from left to right, or was likely a drone, because that can be accomplished, that same thing at this point in time. But in any case, I realized that it could be turned into 3D since the camera moved horizontally and the people were standing still to listen to the speech. Now, if everyone doesn't understand this technique, actually, Tony was discussing the cha-cha. This is kind of another version of cha-cha. Under certain circumstances, you can pluck two positions from a video feed to create what amounts to two camera positions and what is referred to, as he said, a cha-cha. But, you know, it takes a little playing around because you don't know what those angles are going to be. And, of course, this is hyper, which means that the cameras are very far apart, which would be necessary under this kind of a shot. So that was a quick explanation of this one. You could tell it's the thing that'll tell you that it's you. If you see the flag in the distance, you can see it looks a little wonky, to use Jamie's expression, perfect expression. It's a little wonky, but that's what it looked like on the ground. The following images are 2D because it took several more years for me to officially catch the 3D bug. This officer is holding up a freshly graffitied Washington Monument. I took this picture and the next with my Nikkormat camera in November of 1969 when I was an aspiring photographer at the age of 12, much to the chagrin of my parents, who didn't know I was doing it, when I got on a dilapidated school bus alone near St. Mark's Place in Greenwich Village, which was the epicenter of the counterculture at that point in New York City, and took my first trip to Washington, D.C. to photograph what turned out to be the largest anti-war protest of the Vietnam War. Of course, my mother did see me in the background in the news and that night. And so along with this event and many more to follow, I can take credit for the premature graying of both my parents' hair. This is the kind of picture you can get with Tri-X Pan and the trusty light mirroring system in the Nikon Nikkormat camera. This is Les Paul in his favorite sweater and Jose Feliciano jamming at the Iridium Club here in New York. I was fortunate enough to befriend Les and spent many an evening watching him perform with some of the best talent in the world, who are always in awe of him. Very interesting guy. And of course, they're both playing. Can you imagine? Matter of fact, that's one of the things Les would say. People think I'm a guitar. But of course, he's playing his favorite Les Paul. And Jose Feliciano is playing a Les Paul. This is my youngest son, Chris, plying his trade as a fireman, first responder. I have a lot of people in my family that serve, everything from federal agents to soldiers to New York City police. And I'm very proud of all of them, and teachers too. Can't forget them. I'm very proud of all of them. I had just happened by when this scene occurred. He didn't know I was there. I just got out of the car and shot this picture.
So, as mentioned, I used to work up until last March as a production assistant for Live Nation. So I have hundreds of images working from a variety of shows. And at the end of last year, I decided to make a small zine looking back at a few of those shows that I worked in 2019. But naturally, because most of my photographs are taken on an iPhone, they're of pretty low quality. So I thought, well, instead of trying to make them look better, what if I made them look worse, so much so that I create a new composition and then tried to pull something different out of those images. So these are just a few selections from the zine I made, this first one being from the first show I worked in 2019, which was Justin Timberlake.
What I neglected to say is if you're lucky enough to have a pair of chroma depth glasses, this is perfect chroma depth. And I'm sorry, I'll please go on.
Sure. Yeah, so this was the first show I worked this year. They had, I don't know what it was, but like some kind of like linen cylinder hanging above the stage that they were projecting onto. So I had a photograph of that, of some, you know, like forest scenes. And this is originally what the photograph was. And I pulled it into Photoshop and manipulated it from there. Then the second one is of Willie Nelson headlining at the Mountain Jam Festival, which took place in Bethel Woods in June of 2019 at the original location of Woodstock, which was pretty cool. So I used that as inspiration for how I felt during that show. And you can take that for what it means. This one is from Fleetwood Mac at the Prudential Center. And I love Fleetwood Mac. So I tried for this one to do something a little different with some layering. And this is the result. I wasn't really trying to, you know, head in a specific direction for any of these. I sort of just let the distortions, you know, find how I was gonna, you know, get to a final version I really enjoyed. This one is from one of like five or six Jennifer Lopez shows I worked during the summer. And I don't remember if this specific image was from the night that like a huge chunk of Manhattan had a blackout in the middle of the day, but I was there for that. So that was something I was trying to show a little bit in this image. And then this one was from a Regina Spektor show that I worked at the Lunt Fontaine Theater. Live Nation was doing a, you know, a kind of like residency project at this theater on Broadway. And there were a few times where I was the Live Nation rep on site. I believe this was one of them. And it was a small theater. There wasn't a lot going on. So I tried to pull as much as I could out of this image. And this is what I have.